Hey, what's going on, everybody? I've been away from YouTube for a minute. I've been a little under the weather, but I'll be back at y'all. Giving you them videos, them thought-provoking topics. But today I want to talk about some comments that Jim Brown made on Arsenio Hall show recently, and he basically said, well, actually, Arsenio asked him what is his thoughts on Kobe. And, he said, he said Kobe threw Shaq under the bus, referring to when that whole incident popped off with him getting caught with that woman. He basically said in so many words that, yeah, Shaq has cheated on his wife. So obviously, in his home, he had to deal with certain things, and his wife questioning him basically snitched on the brother. Let's just put it out there. And he did. He did throw him under the bus. But, Jim Brown also said that, back when Muhammad Ali was fighting the armed forces, and, obviously for you guys that, study sports history, there was a time where Muhammad Ali did not want to fight in American war. He was very adamant about not fighting. That's a whole nother topic. So, you guys want to know about that, just go do your research and go learn your history on that. But he made a statement saying that we all had Muhammad Ali's back at that time, and we all stood together. And if he had to call or summon again for that same issue, Kobe Bryant would be one of those athletes that he would not call, basically saying that because he was brought up in a different country, he's detached from, I would guess, the Black American struggle, and basically he doesn't put his name on the line for a lot of things. And I get where Jim Brown, was coming from with that. Should he have said that? Probably not. Because a lot of times, within the media and on TV and things, a lot of Black people, we ridicule each other. We say certain comments that we probably should not say on television. And a lot of times these conversations should be talked amongst just us. And maybe a one-on-one conversation, but. Basically what he was saying is that we have athletes like Kobe Bryant, entertainers like Jay-Z with the whole Barney thing that just went on. People like Michael Jordan, Tiger Woods, excuse me, those who don't want to put their name on the line for a cause simply because they might jeopardize endorsement deals. They might jeopardize millions and billions of dollars. And everything is not about money. Everything is not about your image. Everything is not about endorsement deals and everything. Sometimes, as a man, you have to put your name on the line and say, you know what? It's not about my image. It's not about money or nothing like this. It's about me standing up for something that I believe in. And basically just saying that Kobe would not do that. And I agree with him to a certain extent, because, Kobe Bryant is not one of those guys that will jump head out first and put his name into something or say, I'm not going to support this simply because I don't believe in what's going on. He's more the type of guy that, sit back. If they ask him a question about it, he'll say some type of political correct type of answer, or he'll go around the question. Michael Jordan's the same way, going back to when they asked him, I believe something back in the 90s about a Black Democrat running. He was saying, well, Republicans buy my shoes too. It was something, I'm paraphrasing what he said, but it was something to that nature. And basically what he was saying is that I'm not going to put my name out on the line and back it behind a Black Democrat and jeopardize the business and the sales and the image that I have with people that might be against that. I'm about my brand and my brand only. And it's just we have people like that. I can refer back to Jay-Z. Jay-Z could have made an incredible statement by backing out of Barney's deal, because of the discrimination and the racially profiling things that were going on within that company, as well as other companies that practice that every single day. You know, whether it's from hiring or whether it's just racially profiling customers. You know, he could have made a big statement with that, especially with him having the power and the influence he has within hip-hop. But did he do that? No. Because, you know, at the end of the day, a lot of these entertainers are about the money and they're about their brand and their image. They can care less about what's going on in the black community, what's affecting the black community, and so on and so on. So, you know, would Kobe stand with him? You know, who knows? You know, but in my personal opinion, I don't think he would. You know, and what the Stephen A. Smith said this morning on First Take, he was saying that, excuse me, trying to get over this cold and shit, but he was saying that a lot of times athletes and entertainers don't want to put their name on the line because there's not the backing and the unity behind it. Whereas if you look at the 50s and 60s when they were fighting for certain things that we wanted to achieve or stand against within America, everybody was in cahoots with each other. Everybody was unified. It was like, okay, if you take a hit, we gonna take the hit with you. We gonna cushion the backlash you might get. But nowadays, it's like people want you to put your brand, your name, single-handedly out there. You know, and basically take the ridicule and the blowback on your own. So I understand from that point of view too, because you know it's hard to put your name out there. You know that you might not have the solid back and support that you need when you do get that ridicule back from the media and from marketers and so on and so on. So you know it's really a situation that I think really identifies what goes on within entertainment and a lot of our professional athletes and entertainers and why a lot of them don't put their name on the line. But then at the same time, I think a lot of our black entertainers lack, what's the word I'm looking for? They lack courage. They lack the ability to stand for something they believe in and put the image, the money, and the business and everything to the side. Because at the end of the day, you are black, you know, and you're going to take hits for being black. It doesn't matter what type of economical status you have, what type of power, image, or whatever. You know, us as black people, we deal with things on a whole. And, you know, I feel like a lot of times with our entertainers, you know, that market these products out to the black community, a lot of times they don't have the black community's back. Oh, it's cool when, you know, people are going out and buying your products and, you know, making you filthy rich and cherishing you. But when it's time for a lot of our black entertainers to stand for something that is going to benefit the black community as a whole, a lot of times we don't get that same effort. You know, we don't get that same treatment back. So, you know, I just think it's part of our responsibility, too, as a black community to really be wise about who we support within the entertainment industry, because a lot of times black people are viewed as a dollar sign, and that's from white, black, Hispanic, or any other ethnicity. We're a dollar sign to a lot of people, and we don't gain any respect or get people to listen to us until we start controlling our dollar and say, hey, you know what, we're not going to support you financially. But you know, that's my two cents on it. You guys can give me your feedback if you would like. I'm out. Peace.